Season's greetings, fellow elves. I'm here to report to you on Santa's outsourcing and freelance project. The collaboration with the global delivery brand has not worked out as we hoped it would. The large lorries look nice when lit up, but they can't land on most people's roofs. We're settling the claims from the few houses where they landed a lorry. They also can't get up tiny streets and into more remote places. Everyone's been really upset by the Santa call while you were out cards, and we've been deluged with complaints from parents who've been asked to go to the North Pole with three sets of ID in order to collect their children's parents. I don't think we'll be rolling that one out without reconsideration. Outsourcing the reindeer maintenance to the India has turned out to be a bit weird. The reindeer have got used to the hot weather now, though it took some adjustment, but some bright spark has changed their diet. Reindeers have special diets to help them fly, and Rudolph has a very special diet that makes sure that his nose is red. We tried years ago having every reindeer with a red nose, but the truth is if you give more hot input, you get more hot output, and it's just not practical to have all the reindeer with that much output. Nobody told the new Indian elf department, so they put all the reindeer on the same diet, so they all had nice shiny red noses. I think they might have got the memo from HR about equality. Nobody told Santa, and when he was delivering, all the reindeers let loose at once. Santa fell and broke his leg. He was not amused. We're settling the claims with the householder for clearing up the roof and for all the output that went down the chimney. But dear elves, when you're outsourcing, do remember, if you change the input, you change the output. And these things really do need careful thought.